Another beautiful day here in BC, in Canada, and we're gonna try out the new Blackfin Ultra paddleboard today. The previous video, I showed the setup and all that, so if you wanna see what comes in the bag and a basic review of the Blackfin and how this compares to the previous board, check that video out. Aside from that, we're just gonna pump this up, get out on the water, do a little fly fishing. It's gonna be a fantastic day. So come on for the ride. So there's the five-piece paddle that snaps together real easy, and this is the new board. Because it's an Ultra, it folds in half as well as rolls up, so that's why it fits in a smaller bag. Look at that. It's a little damp because I just used it yesterday. Of course, you should always dry off the board. Make sure the valve is in the filling position. I just hit the button. There you go. Okay. Board numero uno, and then we're also gonna use this Ultra all around. I have used this board quite a few times and I fished off of it, and I like this board a lot. There you go. All right, now the old Blackfin X that I have used in previous videos, that was a board that was designed for fishing. This Ultra CX is more of a touring board. It's a lot narrower and it also doesn't have fishing mounts like Scotty mounts and whatnot. So it's not necessarily a fishing board, but I think it will more than suffice for fly fishing. So we're gonna try it out, hop out on this beautiful lake. Look at the sun is shining, and throw a few casts around and see how it performs. So then you can't lose them. That's a good idea. There's nothing better than fly fishing off of a paddleboard. You see the fish under the water. You're just standing out here like literally like you're walking on water. And when you catch a fish, it's super exciting because you don't want to fall off because the water's like 8 degrees and it's freezing cold. These paddle boards are just the perfect tool for mountain lakes like this. And if you're sitting in like a kayak or something like that, you're too low to the water, so you don't get that angle of refraction where you can actually see under the water, you just get the reflection. So paddle boards are just so much better for sight fishing. First thing that I notice is obviously it's a little narrower than previous Blackfins. It doesn't have the Scotty mount, so it's not set up for fishing as much as the previous generation. Because it's narrower, it's way faster. I think iRocker had this board more in mind for touring, more so than fishing. But we've been fly fishing off of it for an hour or so now. And if you're comfortable on a Blackfin X, I think you'd also be comfortable on this. Tracks nice and straight, and because it's narrower, it's way faster and way easier to move around. What a beautiful day to get to test out this new board. As you can see, we are in the mountains here in BC, and it's just glass right now. There's the odd little fish jumping here and there, but not too many. So we'll be opportunists. If we see a fish jump, we're gonna go paddle over and throw a fly at him. I think that's the same thing these guys are doing on a motorboat over here, and you don't even need a motor. Just awesome. It's like a faster Blackfin that I can throw in the back of the truck, takes up half the space. Also has the kayak seat mounts. So if you wanna do, you know, a longer tour and don't want to necessarily have to stand the whole time, you have the option to throw the kayak seat on. iRocker sent us a few kayak seats as well, so we'll be testing those out in a future video. The All Around and the Cruiser, I believe, also have kayak mounts. It's not written on it, but it still has the D mounts where the seats would go. But yeah, overall, I think probably the best balance of speed and stability that I've seen yet. I find the Cruiser and the All Around are a little bit tippier. I'm thinking that's because this board's slightly stiffer with the carbon rail. Look at how easily it turns compared to the old Blackfin. Of course, you can always make it turn faster. Let's see if we can go catch a fish on it. And that's a tall order for me. Hey, that looks good. Think I hit bottom? All right, so we just got back. There is the blackfin, and I think a little better than the previous blackfin X, primarily because it's a little bit lighter and a little bit narrower, which makes it a lot faster. That was kind of my number one gripe with the old blackfin X, was that if you wanted to take it all the way across a big lake like this, it took forever and it was a lot of work. These new boards are awesome. I'm gonna be chucking this thing in the back of the truck and in the plane as much as possible. Fantastic stuff. We'll see you next time. Happy paddling.